Dr. West, courage. What is it? And is courage contagious?
Courage is the great enabling virtue that allows one to realize other virtues like love and hope and faith. To have courage is to be willing to look unflinchingly at catastrophic circumstances and muster the will to overcome the fear, never to fully erase and eliminate the fear, but overcome the fear so that fear does not have the last word, or so that fear does not push one into conformity, complacency, or cowardice. Now, for me, in many ways, the opposite of courage is not simply cowardice, but it's even worse than that. It is indifference. And indifference to evil is more invidious than evil itself, precisely because indifference to evil is contagious. The great Abraham Joshua Heschel used to make this point in almost every text of his, and he's absolutely right. So that courage for me is always a difficult thing to discern and find. There's always not enough courageous folk around. There's too many folk that want to fit in. There's too many folk that want to just go with the grain. There's too many folk who want to simply opt for the seductions and temptations to become drunk with the wine of the world and intoxicated with the felicities of bourgeois existence. Courage says, no, I'll think critically. I will love across the board, across race, across gender, across sexual orientation, across national boundary, and I will hope. I will never allow despair to have the last word, but I will recognize that he or she who has never despaired has never lived. But never allow that despair to have the last word. Courage to think critically. Courage to love. Courage to hope. That, for me, sits at the very center of what the Socratic vocation and prophetic witness are all about. Courage is contagious. It has a way of oozing from one soul to another soul, one person to another person, if we are influenced by the examples of those persons who exemplify the courage to think critically, the courage to love, the courage to hope. That's precisely why the Nelson Mandelas and the Mahatma Gandhis and Martin Luther King Jr.'s and Fannie Lou Hamer's and Phil Barrigan's and Abraham Joshua Heschel's, as courageous examples, do in fact inspire all of us when we're at our best. Do in fact force us to examine our own cowardice, force us to examine our own conformity and complacency. So is courage contagious? Yes, when we have examples of persons who we are willing to take seriously, we are willing to be unsettled by, we are willing to be challenged by, and hence attempt to aspire to the level that they exemplify.